we are now working with five tier ones and three auto OEMs really shows the strong interest in our technology and the role that it's likely going to play here in hybrid electric vehicles and electric vehicles going forward.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. I'm joined by Ideal Power CEO Dan Brdar. Dan, very good to speak with you. What does this fifth tier one automotive supplier engagement signal about B-TRAN's commercial momentum in the EV market?
Well, you know, the fact that we are now working with five tier ones and three auto OEMs really shows the strong interest in our technology and the role that it's likely going to play here in hybrid electric vehicles and electric vehicles going forward as the automakers and their suppliers look for solutions to help them with the two big challenges they faced. One is the cost of electric vehicles and the range anxiety, because our technology helps with both of those items.
Dan, you provided budgetary quotes for millions of SymCool modules. What does that tell us about the scale of opportunity and where this engagement could lead?
You know, it really is enormous. If you think about, you know, how many automobiles are made around the world every year, I mean, it is literally many millions of vehicles. And every vehicle has 5 to 8 contactors in it. And for us, you know, we would go into each one of those contactors that are there to help protect the electrical systems if there's problems with the battery or if it needs to be serviced. So the opportunity is pretty big. And the fact that they wanted this level of quoting from us early on says they want to make sure before they're spending a lot of time and resources buying components from us, evaluating them, starting to work on designs to incorporate it, that it really was going to meet their objectives. And the feedback we've got is, yep, it does. And that's why they placed the order.
How does B-TRAN technology specifically outperform other semiconductor solutions in EV contactor applications?
Well, one of the really important things is an EV contactor is constantly conducting electricity. And you want as much of that energy to go into driving the vehicle as possible. You don't want it turned into heat. And what our technology does is it brings very, very low conduction losses, which means there's very little heat that's generated. There's more useful energy that can go towards providing range for the vehicle versus just being wasted because the semiconductor has a high conduction loss. So it really helps them with improving the range. And we can do it in a technology that's based in silicon. We don't need to go to any exotic materials like we see a lot of other companies doing.
Dan, you've said solid-state contactors will overtake electromechanical ones in 5 years. What milestones should investors watch out for as Ideal Power helps drive that shift?
Well, as we get awarded programs that are actually about being designed in, you actually start to see that trend happening. Because while the design process is fairly long for automobiles, once they commit to actually designing you into a platform, it's a very sticky application. It ultimately means there's big volume coming as a result of that. So I think you're going to see some announcements from us, probably even in the near term here, about being awarded programs for EV contactors.
Dan, I hope you'll continue to keep us posted on your progress. Thank you very much for speaking with us today, and congratulations on that contract.
Thank you. Appreciate it. Have a good day.
Dan Brdar, the CEO of Ideal Power.